Hey. Oh, how good is that? Who doesn't love a bit of comfort food? If you're anything like me, you are eating your feelings right now. And one of our favourite chefs, Warren Mendes, knows all the tricks and is back to share the ultimate comfort food recipe. G'day, Wazza, hey, how are you?
How are you guys? Good to be with you again.
You too. Where's your hat?
My hat, look, the hat was far too big, so I just kind of had to get rid of it. It was becoming a fire hazard in the kitchen.
He's too busy wearing the crown for our favourite chef. Hey, Woz, what comfort recipe are you sharing this morning?
Look, I think nothing screams comfort food more than some mashed potato. I know, Tristan, you're going to agree with me there.
Yes.
But obviously mashed potato and then kind of a roast dinner, roast chicken. But instead of having to do the whole roast chicken, we're just going to do some beautiful golden pieces of chicken. So the two of those combined together with a creamy mustard sauce, sit on the couch, I think it kind of all the lockdown woes will disappear. So that's what we're going to be doing. So the kind of trick to get some beautiful golden roast chicken is to get some of these chicken thighs, and I've got skin on chicken thighs. Now the trick to get perfect, beautiful, golden chicken is to start in a cold pan. So this pan's cold, and you go skin side down, place the chicken in there, and then you'll place that over the heat. And what happens is all that beautiful fat from the chicken slowly draws out and it starts to kind of caramelize in its own fat. And I mean, cooking in all sorts of types of fat means flavor. And so basically this is what you'll get left with. You'll get this awesome crispy chicken. I mean, if you look at that there, that's like crackling, that stuff. So you've got these beautiful chicken pieces. They've cooked for about 15 minutes in the pan. And then what you'll see here is I've got all this beautiful flavor in the pan. So all these like kind of brown bits, that's flavor. And we're gonna make a super, super, super quick sauce. So chicken there, that's done. And all I'm gonna add is some mustard. So I've got some whole grain and Dijon. Whatever you've got, if you want some hot English, that's gonna work too. If you want it fiery, and then some thyme. And then we'll just stir that into the pan. And then, cause it's never too early in lockdown, a little bit of white wine as well. And if you drink it too, that's absolutely fine. Bit of wine, a bit of cream, of course. Cream makes everything better. I think it's a medical fact. And then we're going to stir that. Now, while that cooks down a little bit, we're going to talk about the important stuff, the mash. So, mash. I've cooked some beautiful plain mash here. And I've kind of gone in with a heap of butter and cream, of course. But what I've done is I took a whole head of garlic. And then if you put it in the center of a piece of foil, wrap it up, and now roast that for about 30 minutes in an oven at about 180. You get left with this beautiful caramelized garlic. And once that cools, all we're gonna do is go straight into the mash, and it kind of squeezes out all that garlic.
Oh, wow.
Wow.
Hey, Waz, can I ask you about those potatoes?
Getting all over my fingers, but that's fine.
Yes. When I'm doing my mashed potato, I leave the skins on.
Oh.
And people think that's a bit weird.
Yeah.
What about you?
Well, then that's okay. That's kind of like cold cannon, isn't it? Like when you do your Irish cold cannon potatoes, you leave the skins on. That's fine. All that you're not going to get this beautiful white texture, though. That's the only thing. You're going to kind of have lumps. But, you know, there's nothing wrong with leaving the skins on at all. There's also nutrients in the skin, and sometimes you just couldn't be bothered, as long as you're getting a bunch of mashed potato.
I mean, granted, so I washed them there, first, but some people think it's a bit weird.
As long as you give a no, I don't think it's weird at all. You can do what you want, Tristan. I think you're actually becoming quite a good chef yourself. Bit of nutmeg. In large quantities is a hallucinogenic, but in small quantities it's absolutely beautiful. So stir that into there and we have the best mash. So straight into a bowl.
That's good, huh?
I've got the couch calling me already.
Oh,
and
that's me.
A decent portion of this mash.
The kids would totally eat this, wouldn't they, Woz?
Oh, 100%. This is like, this is your roast chicken and mash that you'd usually have on a Sunday, except we're doing it during the week. Mm. The kind of the food stylist in me can't help it. We're going to make some beautiful waves of mash so that we can trap all that sauce in there.
It does look great and looks hearty.
And then in with some
comforting
golden chicken. There we go. Just a couple of pieces. I'll probably have more than that myself. And then the sauce, which you can look in this pan here, which has gone all golden, and there's just golden all the brown goodness in there.
Oh, there might be a little kick off that with the mustard as well, huh? Beautiful.
Oh, yeah, just a little, not too much of a kick. The kids will still be able to eat this. There, whatever herbs you have in the house, maybe some chives, done.
for the grass.
You can check out more of Warren's recipes. How
Dinner's
good
made.
Does that look? At Warren Mendes on Instagram. And Warren is back shortly for Ask the Chef, where you can he'll answer all of your cooking questions. Was we're not even there, but I feel like I need to unbutton my pants and start eating.
Look, I'm probably going to even have seconds. It's actually really, really good, really easy.
I'll be waking up tonight.
We won't tell. We'll see you soon, lovely.
See you soon.